James C. Justice II, the governor of West Virginia, made a fortune in 2009 when he sold Bluestone Resources, a collection of his best West Virginia coal mines, to Russian company Mekel OAO for $500 million plus several hundred million dollars in Mekel stock. That deal was enough to push Justice into the ranks of the Forbes 400 in 2011, with an estimated net worth of $1.1 billion, later peaking at $1.7 billion. But the coal industry has deteriorated, and with it, the Justice family fortunes. In 2015, after coal prices plunged, the Russians insisted that the Justice family buy Bluestone back. So Justice paid $5 million for his old company, but also assumed some $300 million in environmental and legal obligations. Justice, in new court documents, says that the Russians left behind a shambles. The business had been mismanaged under Mekel ownership, burdening it with substantial reclamation, union and trade obligations. Despite the challenges, Jim Justice, 69, and his son James C. Justice III, or J., say in their lawsuit that they have maintained the objective of returning Bluestone to profitability. Never mind that Justice long ago earned the reputation of being a businessman who never pays his bills, they just needed some more capital. Justice found a willing party in Greensill Capital, an upstart supply chain lender, which in April 2019 extended the Justices the first of some $850 million in outstanding loans. Greensill had good reason to want to build a relationship with Justice, because Bluestone's metallurgical coal had a natural buyer in the form of Greensill's biggest client, GFG Alliance. Run by UK entrepreneur Sanjeev Gupta, GFG manages an empire of mostly second-hand steelworks and smelters across the UK and around the world. Notable assets include the last major steelworks in Scotland, Britain's last aluminium smelter, the largest electric arc furnace in the UK for melting scrap metal. Gupta built his steel empire with $5 billion borrowed via Greensill. Greensill, which in March filed for insolvency in the UK, and is now in receivership, was not a traditional lender. Rather, Greensill was an enthusiastic practitioner of supply chain finance methods such as invoice discounting, in which a business unwilling to wait 60 or 90 days for a customer to pay would sell its receivables to Greensill, which would cut them a check immediately, minus a fee, then collect from the customer later. It was a lending practice that founder Lex Greensill cultivated in his early days financing crops for farmers in his native Australia, where he grew up on a sweet potato farm. Greensill attracted plenty of believers. Credit Suisse CS invested some $10 billion. Investment advisor GAM Holdings put in $2 billion. They packaged up Greensill's supply chain-backed loans and sold them on to institutional investors. Private equity powerhouse General Atlantic invested $250 million for Greensill Capital Equity in 2018. SoftBank Vision Fund put in $1.